Hi, I'm Mac McCarthy, and I help people with their breakups. Today, I'm going to review Breakup Brad or Brad Browning's YouTube video titled "How to Make Your Ex Miss You," new and updated for 2016. It's about an 8-minute clip that's mostly a infomercial to buy his book. I haven't read his book. But judging by the material that he repeats over and over again in his videos and the way he talks, I probably wouldn't buy it. Now, am I telling you not to buy it? Go ahead. If you're out there collecting as much information as you can, but the way this guy approaches things, I mean, for 3 or 4 minutes, he's talking about himself and his book, and then he gets to the first thing. And the first thing is the no contact rule, which everyone knows already, and he states it as like this is the greatest way to get their attention, and everyone states it. I stated on my channel to go with the no contact rule, and you can dice that and slice that and put it into any slot you want to put it in, but basically you're cutting off contact, right? But then he goes a step further, and his next, and I agree with the no contact, it's one of the first steps in breaking up if you want them back. How to make them miss you. Absolutely true. Okay. But the thing is, when you watch the video, he leads up like he's giving you some really big nugget that you wouldn't know about. And the no contact rule. Okay. So the next one he mentions is sending your ex a text with a question. And he gives the example of, let's say you had a beach that you used to go to together, and you're saying, like, hey, how did you get to Dillon Beach again? And they're supposed to think, ooh, who are you taking to the beach with you? Wow, it's, and you're reaching out to them like indirectly, and it makes them think. And this is the part that I don't like. Okay, he uses the word, it will almost guarantee. That is bullshit. When you hear guarantees on any of this stuff, myself included, I do not guarantee you getting an ex back by taking my advice. Okay? What I preach is send me your story, and it's a good first step, and we can go from there and see what's going on in your individual breakup. When you get people out there saying that if you send someone a text message, okay, stating that, like, yeah, that place we used to go for dinner. I'm thinking of taking someone there tonight. How much is it for two? This is the kind of stuff he's saying. Like, you're indirectly showing them that you're gonna go out with someone else, and they're wondering. And then you're making them think about that moment you were together at that place. Could that work? Possibly. So does it sound cheesy as hell to me? Yeah. What if it doesn't work? That's the what's the loss involved, right? That's the part that gets me, is like, if it doesn't work, you didn't just end up being where you were before. You end up 2 steps backwards as appearing needy, weak, and trying too hard. If you're in the no contact rule, roll with the no contact rule. Stick with it. Don't send a message trying to get their attention. If you have a smart ex and they know you really well, they'll know what you're trying to do, right? And the only thing you're working on is hoping that they're needy also, especially if this is within the first month that you broke up. He doesn't mention a time frame or anything. If this is in the first month and you just kind of mention something like that, you're throwing out a lure that's not going to catch a lot of fish. That's all I'm going to say. And this guy's touting it as a guarantee. I just don't agree with that. As a almost a guarantee that you're going to get their attention. Total BS, in my opinion. Is it possible to work? Yeah, sure. Okay, use it as a tactic, as a compelling partial guarantee to guarantee. Absolutely not. So the next thing he mentions as he's talking about his book for more great tips, is how you want them to find out that you're going out on the town and you're doing well without them. And that's absolute, that's part of no contact. You're going out, you're taking care of yourself, you're having fun. What he's saying is, like, you want them to find out. What he's suggesting is, like, maybe Facebook pictures and stuff like that. Yeah, that could work. Again, you're attracting a needy character over there. And what if it doesn't work, right? What if that doesn't work? And he writes this quote, "I'm awesome. I'm going to enjoy my fun and exciting life with or without you." That just sounds like a Valley Girl from LA or something. I mean, it's very typecasted as far as who would use that, you know? So when you're trying to give off, you know, I'm looking back at some of the exes I had, and if I wanted to get them back, and my message to them was, you know, I want to convey, I'm awesome, and I'm going to enjoy my fun and exciting life with or without you, it wouldn't work. And I wouldn't want it to work, right? The no contact rule, right, mentioned in my other video, 7 principles to get an ex back, which I review Corey Wayne's ideas and agree with most of what he has to say. If you're going to go no contact, you're all in. You're getting all your chips and you're putting them on the table. You don't go in and go, oh yeah, I'm also going to throw in this tricky little text that she's going to remember that beach we used to go to. And maybe, you know, she's going to wonder, why am I asking her how to get to that beach again? Or maybe I'll post these photos on Facebook and put it at a time when she's going to be looking, or, you know, message her friend that I went to the club last night because I'm awesome. I'm going to enjoy my fun and exciting life with or without you, quote unquote. Come on, man. I mean, I just, it could work for a small percentage of the world that talks and acts this way, but to act like this is like a guarantee of getting your ex back, the blanket guarantee is no guarantee. The blanket guarantee is move on, don't look back, and don't expect them to come back. And if they do, it's a bonus. And that bonus, you are going to say, I don't know if I need it. I don't know if I need the bonus, but if I, yeah, you know what, let's see how this works out. Let's get together and have dinner and see how it goes. And then I'll decide myself after dinner if it's going in the right direction and we can go there. But this kind of cheesy stuff, I'm awesome and I'm going to enjoy my fun and exciting life with or without you. Oh God, that is needy, needy, needy behavior in trying to get your ex back. And it's embarrassing. And when that kind of stuff doesn't work, you go to ground zero instantly. You are a laughingstock. What if they find out that you are, you know, just trying, you know, if they sniff out, like, you don't know how to, for example, going back to this, well, you just kind of send them a message like, yeah, how do you get to that beach again? Oh, and then you're expecting, oh, the one we used to go to on Valentine's Day? Yeah, that one. I just want to know how to get there. I'm going there tomorrow. Oh, what are you going there for? This is what you're expecting to get back. I don't know, you know, I got some plans. I'm going over there. I just forgot how to get there. You know how to get there? And then she's supposed to respond, oh my God. And then you just leave her hanging, thinking that you are going with another woman to that beach and she can't get it out of her head. What if her response is yet, oh yeah, why don't you check Google Maps or Google it? What if she says that? Where do you go with that then? Oh, it's just bam. Fuck you. You know what I mean? It's just the comeback. That's the beauty of no contact. There's no comeback. There's no smack in the mouth, right? That's the thing when you do contact and your intention is to get back together and your intention is to want them back and it doesn't work, then you look weak and needy and it's not attractive, right? Or if you are weak and needy in your approach, you're just attracting a weak and needy partner, and it's not going to work long term, okay? That's why you stay in, all in on the no contact. That's why, check out 7 principles of how to get your ex back, the video I made, or even Corey Wayne's. I'll plug him because he does good work. But this kind of stuff, sorry, man, I'm not signing off on it. I am not signing off on this. How to make your ex miss you. Updated 2016 version. Give me a break, man. Seriously. Seriously. So, just for starters, write your story out. right when you break up, or if it's been 2 months, 3 months, you're having trouble with it, write out what happened, write it down on paper, type it out, send it to me. I'll take a look at it for free. I'll send you a response. Send it to writemac.com, WRITEMAC.com. And I'll take a look at it, go through it, give you some sound advice, give you some information. I might suggest the no contact rule, right? But I wouldn't give you some guaranteed text question, right? We'll go through your story, see where you go from there. And if you want some 1 hour paid coaching, we can go do that also. But stay away from guarantees when it comes to getting your ex back. Just that's the one thing I want you to know. Anyone that mentions a guarantee, that's not where you want to be headed, because where you're at is you want to be getting up and over that hill. And if she doesn't want to follow you, then you're okay. You're on to the next one. You're on to the next ship. You're on to the next bus. It's fine. And that's what she's going to be attracted to. That's going to be your best shot. And then you're going to be the one to say, you know what? Yeah, I think this will work out. You know what? It ain't going to work out because I've already moved on. And that's the best place to be in, right? Have a good one.